Whoa. What's up, Vikes? Welcome back to this week's episode of Viking Visions. As you know, our school has been through a couple hardships, but
today we're here to show you what our Viking community is doing to help us out. Let's go check it out.
I'm here with
Dominic Dudley.
And since you've been here, what was your favorite part of being at Montgomery?
The last rally of last year, when everybody was wearing their class colors and they was all doing the chants and we had that little competition, that was my favorite part. That was super hyped. It reminded me of when I was in high school.
Hey, I'm here with
Yuri, and my favorite part of being here in Montgomery was being part of Avid and getting the opportunity to go to UC Berkeley and like learning about the campus and stuff.
Thank you. I'm here with
Devon Jenkins.
And how have you seen the campus improve?
Aesthetically wise, a lot of new buildings. Since I've been here, I started school here in 91 through 94 when I graduated. The thing I've seen the most improve out of the school itself is the diversity. So when I went to school here, it wasn't as many as minorities on campus. So now that here we are in 2024, I see a big shift in that. So that's the improvement I've seen the minorities in the diversity here. It's a lot more people here. So.
Thank you.
That worked.
And that's gonna conclude it for this week's episode of Viking Visions. I hope you guys enjoyed it.
Make sure y'all hit that like and subscribe button, and we'll see y'all on the next one.
What's up, Vikings? April 17th, track senior night, be there.
It's gonna be at the Viking track field, so be there and support your seniors on a great season.
This past week, our track team had a very tough dual meet against Santa Rosa, and our best track members ran at twilight at the SRJC on Saturday.
Today is the last swim meet of the year. It is senior night against Santa Rosa at Ridgeway. Be there.
What's up, brother? Thank you for tuning in.
Special team, special plays, special players.
See you later, Vikings.
Hey Vikings, campus beautification is happening on April 21st at 9 a.m. Be there to make our campus beautiful.
Bring your own tools and gloves and be there.
Greetings Vikings, today we're going to take a look at Gardening Club. Let's go check them out.
So in the garden this year, we are obviously like have all these amazing boxes and trellises. So we're hoping to plant more plants in these boxes and also have a nice pathway going through this. And maybe some more trees to provide more shade for students and an outdoor learning space. And so it's been kind of slow because we've been working on our irrigation. But yeah, we're hoping to have a lot of stuff growing by the end of the year.
Yeah, and our next event is April 21st, 9 a.m. to 12 p.m. We're having a campus beautification, and for the garden, we're just going to be cleaning and possibly planting some things in these little boxes.
For those of you who want to keep track of the club, you can follow them on Instagram at Monty Garden Club. Thank you.
Hey Vikings! Class officer elections are still going on, and the link to the TikTok is in the highlights in the ASB Instagram.
Voting ends tomorrow, so vote for who you would like to represent your class now.
Hello, and welcome back to Montgomery Wildlife. And in this bulletin, I'd like to inform you of an upcoming performance that the drama team has been cooking up. They will be performing Roger and Hammerstein's Cinderella. It shares some aspects of Disney's Cinderella, except it's a musical and originally made to be viewed on television, but was adapted to be performed on stage. And it was also so popular, they decided to remake it twice. This is also one of our biggest performances yet, with inclusion from drama, band, choir, art, and the dance team. And you wouldn't want to miss a performance as big as this one. Also, tickets can be purchased through this QR code. Be sure to grab them quick, because who knows how quick these tickets can sell out.
Hey Lila, when can I see Cinderella?
You can see Cinderella at April 19th at 7 p.m. That's opening night. But it's going on for 2 weekends, so you can't miss it. At the PAC, and get your tickets at the business office.
Hey Jones, what's the question of the week?
The question of the week is, would you survive a zombie apocalypse and for how long?
Ariel, how long do you think you last?
3 months.
I say like a good 2 months.
I say a good year.
Calm little 6 months.
As somebody who's watched every season of The Walking Dead, I do think I could survive the zombie apocalypse for about 3 months.
I would prioritize water and weapons, maybe like ammunition too, because I can talk about that because we're talking about a zombie apocalypse.
I think I would be able to last probably a couple weeks before I stress myself out way too much.
I think I'd give myself a month, you know, decent time.
I think I could last as long as I can outrun Karina.
Oh, so I think that I would be able to survive temporarily because I would like kill people, which is not really my thing.
It's gonna be tough. I don't think I'll survive very long, to be honest, but I'll do my best.
Thanks for watching.
See you guys next time.